I'm here today to talk about the growth mindset. Obviously, this has nothing to do with height, because if it did, I would not be the one giving this talk. Event plus response determines the outcome. E plus R equals O. This has been called the success equation. An event happens in our life, and our response to that event determines the outcome. We have no control over the event, but what we do control is our response, which then influences the outcome. That outcome then becomes the next event that we must respond to. This equation continually builds on itself so that it plays out in both microscopic and macroscopic view of our lives to ultimately determine our success and happiness. The response piece, the R, represents what we can't control in life, which is our effort, our actions, and our attitude. I first heard about this equation in an article talking about the leadership group Focus 3 that Urban Meyer worked with and that he then brought in to work with his Ohio State football team. The most dramatic E plus R equals O moment of my life occurred the time I signed up to do an Ironman triathlon. At the beginning of the swim, another athlete kicked me in the goggles so that the plastic nose bridge broke off. So there I was, treading water in the middle of the Ohio River, goggles. And I had two options, two ways I could respond to this event. I could swim to the riverbank and climb out and call it a day, or I could channel my inner Dory and just keep swimming. So with no goggles, I swam over 2 miles and was able to achieve my goal of finishing the race under 10 hours. I'm here today to specifically examine the response piece of this equation through a growth mindset lens. There are two distinct types of mindsets, fixed and growth. And I liken the difference between these to the difference between writing with a pen and writing with a pencil. A fixed mindset is similar to writing with a pen in that once it has been written, it cannot be changed. Whereas a growth mindset is similar to writing with a pencil in that once it has been written, it can be erased and then edited. Fixed mindset believes that intelligence and talent cannot be changed over time. There are a predetermined amount of both intelligence and talent in each person. Whereas a growth mindset believes that intelligence and skill can be developed over time through consistent, repeated, intentional effort. With the growth mindset, each individual assumes responsibility for their success by controlling their R piece of the equation, controlling their effort, their actions, and their attitude. Success with the growth mindset is similar to a journey through a mountain range, with the most important aspects being that it is not quick or easy, and it's full of both highs and lows. For every mountaintop of success that you reach, there are two valleys filled with failures and non-successes on either side. These valleys connect the mountaintops together to form a mountain range. And the most important qualities on this mountain range journey of success with the growth mindset are intentional hard work, embracing challenges, simplifying the task, and long-term perseverance. The first pillar of the growth mindset is intentional hard work. Hard work is similar to putting one foot in front of the other, day after day, year after year, on this mountain range journey. Seventh grade. So many different words pop into my head when I hear those two words. Change, awkward, growing, immature, embarrassing. But hard work isn't necessarily one of them. Close your eyes and picture your first class, your first day of seventh grade. Hold on to that picture and open your eyes. For me, this was at Pickerington Junior High, and it was a home ec class where we got to make a pillow, pizza, and cookies. Fast forward 13 years later, and I am now that teacher welcoming in seventh graders on their first day for their first class at the same school, in that same room. I teach a robotics class. And although students don't get to bake cookies like I did, I do bake cookies every Friday for those students who've worked hard all week. I love so many things about being a robotics teacher, but what I love the most is the ability to promote the growth mindset, particularly the hard work aspect. Raise your hand if you hated group projects growing up, where you would end up doing the majority of the work, but everyone else in your group would get a blanket grade because of your effort. Now my class is completely group project based, but each student receives an individual grade based on individual effort. Students know from the first day that I grade based off of hard work and effort. I purposely focus and promote hard work and effort because these represent a student's art piece of the equation in their lives now and in the future. They can always control their effort, their actions, their attitude. The second pillar of the growth mindset deals with one's use of challenges and failures. Those with a fixed mindset shy away from challenges because they believe that it could potentially expose them as not being naturally smart or talented. Whereas those with a growth mindset embrace challenges because it allows them to see where they are in relation to where they want to be. Challenges provide a measuring stick and feedback to improve upon. They recognize that the only real growth is through challenge. I've not always been a robotics teacher. I used to teach sixth grade math and science. The opportunity to teach this robotics class came up, and I was very hesitant because I had absolutely no prior experiences with robotics. I ultimately accepted the position and embraced the challenge of my life with the attitude of, do one thing a day that scares you. With this attitude of doing one thing a day that scares you, challenges and failures are turned into learning opportunities. At some point in time, the word failure has transformed from an action to an identity, when all it represents is an opportunity to begin to get more intelligent. Because of this view of failure, those with a growth mindset embrace challenges and take more risks. The third pillar of the growth mindset is simplifying the task. This involves breaking what you want to do or accomplish into clear, concise, attainable steps. The key being making the steps unambiguous and right on the edge of your current skills and desired skills. Simple, however, does not mean easy. It is simple to wake up early. You get out of bed when your alarm goes off, but not always easy. It is simple to save money. You do not buy things you do not absolutely need, but not always easy. It is simple to lose weight. You burn more calories than what you take in, but definitely not easy. The mountain range journey of success is simple, but far from easy. For some, simplifying the task actually makes things more difficult because there are no excuses to hide behind, since the task has been broken down into manageable steps. Those with a growth mindset embrace simplicity because it allows them to focus on their R variable in lives, their effort, their actions, their attitude. I believe that leadership is spelled EXAMPLE. I've been fortunate to achieve success in short course triathlons. I've been the national runner-up for my age group 4 different times. I earned a bronze medal at the age group world championships. And last year, USA Triathlon ranked me number 3 for all triathlon distances in my age group. For every one of those mountaintop of successes that I just listed, there were 2 battles filled with it not working out as planned and falling flat on my face on either side. I've been competing in triathlons for over 10 years now, and the hardest part of this mountain range journey has been the long-term perseverance to go from mountaintop back down to the valley and back up to the top again. This long-term perseverance represents the 4th pillar of the growth mindset. Part of this journey for me was in 2014. The year prior, I'd finished 2nd in my age group at nationals, and following this, I'd fixated on winning that next year. Winning was all that mattered. Race day came, and unfortunately, it was far from my day. I'd finished in 11th place. However, 3 weeks later, I had the opportunity to compete in the world championships against those same competitors. Between these 2 races, I shifted my mindset to focus on racing the best race I was possible of, giving it my best effort, no matter what place I was in. I have no control over how fast others are. I can only control my effort and my mindset. That was my own piece of the equation. As I finished the race and sat down and cheered at the finish line, I had no idea what place I'd finished. However, I was genuinely satisfied because I'd achieved my goal. I'd given my best effort with my best attitude. About a half hour later, they came over the loudspeaker and announced results. I'd finished 3rd place in the world, earning a bronze medal and beating those same competitors who'd beat me 3 weeks earlier. The running joke among my friends is that I'm always a bridesmaid and never a bride at these national and world competitions. But I always tell them 2 things. 1, it will never be for lack of effort. And 2, it hasn't happened yet. The growth mindset represents the power of yet. Through consistent, repeated, intentional effort, yet transforms into what's next. That is the beauty of yet. Your tombstone will say four things. It will say your name, the date that you were born, a dash, and the date that you died. Three of those four things, you have no control over. What you can control, however, is your dash. The dash represents the life that you have lived. Live your dash by maximizing your effort, your actions, your attitude. Thank you.